Hello, everyone. It's the same day, September 12th, but I'm gonna probably put this up tomorrow. I go out to relax. Try to, anyway. Run a couple of errands. And I get to the mailbox, and I have all these advertisements again for a mortgage. Three different names they use for me, and that was my first married name. My second name is hyphenated, and that was because of my kids, because the doctors and dentists kept screwing up the names, and it's a long story. But anyway, and then there's my married name to the narc. Funny, because that's what the bank accounts knew. Yeah. It's just weird how this keeps happening. You know, after the bank robbery, all of a sudden. Just all of a sudden. Yeah. And the timing is just amazing. But like I said, there's no such thing as a coincidence when there's a psychopath involved. Not really. Maybe a 1% chance. That's about it. So anyway, this is just basically a bitch and complain session. I come home to the jackhammer. I thought the guys were done for the day. No, 6:30 at night, and jackhammer's going. Yeah, you'd think it'd be really great living in the suburbs, especially where I live, but everybody has very little yards. So what happens is you got lawnmowers going off every 5 minutes, leaf blowers going. If they have a lawn service, the good thing about if they have a lawn service is they get that done in like 5 minutes. Then you've got everybody who's got a dog in their yard. Big stupid dog, big black dog, yippy yappy dog. Those are the names I gave them. It's worrisome because they're like unsupervised most of the time. I keep a real close eye on my dogs, believe it or not, even though Buddy slipped out of his collar. I was going to give him a bath. And what he does, like I said before, is he'll start just walking away, like he's looking for someone. Like I said, probably his last owners. So that was an accident. I paid for it. Yep. So did he. Night in the pound. Yeah, night in jail. Poor thing. He's still recovering. He's doing okay though. Yeah. Anyway, so you'd think it would be, you know, it looks really nice living here, and it is really nice, and the school district is like freaking amazing. It really is. It's like practically a college preparatory high school. But god damn the noise. It's like every 5 minutes, a lawnmower, a leaf blower, a dog. Then I have to worry about Big Stupid Dog. That's the name I gave him. And he is stupid. I met him. He's just a big stupid dog, which is scary because I've had a Malinois mix that was aggressive and dumb as a bag of rocks. Bad combination. She used to run away all the time. God, she could run. The only dog that could outrun her was a dog. I was going to say Dalmatian, but Greyhound. We were at the dog park one time and she was racing, literally, a Greyhound, and it outran her and she stopped. She looked so disappointed that it outran her. Yeah, it did. That was the only dog that could outrun that, her. I should have given her back. I hate to say that. I adopted her. I didn't know what a Malinois was at the time. They're not that common, and they're not good dogs to have unless you have property and they're outside guard dogs. That's it. That dog could jump and run. Oh my god. But she was such a pain in the ass to train. Yeah, it took me a year or 2 years to potty train her. Yeah, because I got her when she was like 9 months old. That you'll see her in some of my videos if you go to my other page. Man, that dog was awful. And the older she got, the more aggressive she got. She was mean. I should have taken her back. And I even told the narc that a few times. I'm like, we should take her back. Can't handle this dog. I can't handle her. I don't know why, because at the time she looked like a lab, but she was really a Malinois, mostly. And but I kept her 10 years. She died of anal cancer, most aggressive form of cancer. It's really sad. That's the only time she became even a little bit submissive. Yeah. Anyway, and cooperative. Anyway, so I come home, 6:37 p.m. The jackhammer is still going. Thought the guys were off for the day, but the good news is that they're probably gonna work till dark, and maybe they're gonna get the job done in one day. And that way, I don't have to listen to this anymore. Yeah, lawnmowers, leaf blowers, jackhammers. Oh, and the other neighbor just before this one. The day before was having their roof done, so you had to listen to that. I'm not getting too much sleep as I got that mail again. Wondering why all three of my names are being used. My former names. I was tied to the bank account. It's a mystery for now. Well, not really. It was a bank robbery. What a little shit. That's what I get to come home to. Oh, meanwhile, he's like, just sell the house. Just sell the house. Okay, that's what I was supposed to do. Right? Wasn't I? Isn't that what you said to do? Just sell the house, right? Fair and square. That's the way you made it sound. What a little shit. This probably isn't gonna make sense to anyone, but I'm just irritated. 'Cause I went out to relax, and then I come home to a jackhammer again. Like, you gotta be fucking kidding me, man. As if the lawnmowers and leaf blowers weren't bad enough. Like I said, going off every 5 minutes. God damn. It's better than the city, let me tell you that. You live in the city, all you hear is sirens and car alarms. I mean, 24/7, all going off all the time. My bridesmaid lived down there, and she had sublet a condo from someone. I remember being there one night, going, "How can you stand this?" I mean, it was so noisy. So, anyway, it's not gonna make too much sense to anyone, maybe, or not. It'll make sense to me later. I just don't want to forget to record that. Peace out.